हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स प्रैक्टिसेस फॉर क्लास 11। टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर लिस्ट मैनिपुलेशन। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर स्टूडेंट्स, आई वांट टू गिव यू अ बिट मैसेजेस रिलेटेड टू द कोविड सिचुएशन राइट नाउ। ओके, सो एज यू आर नोइंग दिस होल वर्ल्ड एंड आवर कंट्री इज ऑल्सो सफरिंग फ्रॉम दिस पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन। सो हियर not only the part of a teacher or a particular health worker is there, it is also part of everyone, every citizen of this country and every particular single person living on this earth, that they have to be means careful about the norms which has to be taken. Okay, that means the steps, the activities which we are performing right now have to be means quite related with the rules which we need to follow. Okay, that means we have to be very vigilant according to the social distancing. Okay, we have to be very careful whether we are wearing the mask or not. Okay, we are just using the proper sanitizers or not. Okay, so whenever you are going to a particular crowded place, whenever you are visiting someone of your friend's house or neighbor's house, just be careful you are wearing the mask and maintaining a proper social distancing. Okay, so be careful and be aware of these situations. Okay, we will fight the situations and we will get back to our normal routines very soon. Okay, so let's start our video. So in the last part we have discussed about the list manipulations and we have also discussed what is the indexing in list. Okay, so today we are going to discuss further about the list slicing. Okay, now see here, we are having a list here. List elements are 10 12 14 20 24 30 34, you can see this one. Okay, so in this list, if we are mentioning list 3 colon 30, okay, so what is this 3 colon 30 symbolizing? That the starting index is 3 and it has to go till 29. Okay, so if you are saying that it has to go till 29 from 3, so that means what? The index should start from 3, so 0 1 2 3, so the 3 index is 20. Okay, so it has started from 20 and it has to go till 29. Okay, but the 29 index is not there. Okay, obviously here we are having 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. Okay, these 8 indexes are there. So how can we go till that 29 index? Okay, so in that case, whatever is the last index, it will be taken and all the elements from 3 to the last elements of this list will be printed. Okay, so here you can see the list is 20, 22, 24, 30, 32 and 34. Okay, similarly, if we are writing list minus 15 colon 7, so again, in this negative indexing, you are knowing this, that you cannot start the indexing from minus 15 because the minimum which you can go is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8 and minus 9. So the last index at 10 will be minus 9. So how can you go till minus 15? Okay, so it will start it from the beginning of that list and it will go till the index 6. Okay, why 6? Because it has mentioned 7, so it will go a bit one step earlier, so it will go till the index 6. So the 6 index is at 0 1 2 3 4 5 and 6, you're at 30. Okay, so if you are going till 30, that means it is going to use that particular index there. Okay, now see, if you are going to print that list, it is going to print the list according to this format. Okay, now if you are taking another list here, 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5 comma 6 comma 7 comma 8, so in this you are writing L1 2 colon 5, so 2 colon 5 will print the list from, that is 4 5 and 6. Why it is there? Because the index is starting from 0 1 2, that is from 4, and the ending index is at 5, so the 5 index will go one step earlier, so it will go till the index number 4, so it will print the elements 4 5 and 6. Okay, I think it is clear for you about the indexes. Okay, also if you mention the step there, okay, so if you are talking about the step, so it will go from the 0 index till 9 index and it will skip every second element there. Okay, so skip one element is there in between, so it will start from 0, it will go till 10 and it will just skip one element. Okay, so 0 colon 10 comma 2 will go from 0 to 9, but it will take one step gap. Okay, so it will print the first element, that is the 0 index element, it will skip the one index element, it will go to the second element. Similarly, the elements from 10 to 34 will be printed like this: 10, then 14, then 22, then 30 and then 34. Okay, so this is the way you can do the indexing. Okay, also if you see this one, list colon colon 3, so in this we are having the starting index. So starting index is 0 because we are not having anything in the starting index, and also stopping index is not there, so it has to take all the list, but the step is given 3, so you have to skip every 2 elements. Okay, so the first element will be printed 10, and then 2 elements will be left, 12 and 14, in the next element will be printed 20. Then again 22 and 24 will be left out, and then next element will be printed as 30. Okay, so in this way we can do the slicing of the list. Okay, now let's move further and just go to this part, that is list functions and method. So the first method is the len function. Okay, so what this len function is doing, it is storing the length of the list. Okay, so that elements which are there in the list, it has to be counted, and the frequency of that elements, sorry, don't say the frequency, the counting of the elements, that how many elements are there, that will be the length of the list. Okay, so here you can see this one, we have got a list len 1 2 3. So if you are going to write list length of 1 comma 2 comma 3, so you are knowing that the list is 1 comma 2 comma 3, which is enclosed in the square brackets. Okay, so if you will count the number of elements there, so the number of elements is 3, so the length is also 3. If you'll go to this list one, 4 comma 2 comma 9 comma 1 comma 4 comma 5, so in this case you can see that the length of list one will be 4. Why? Because the elements are 1 2, and this 9 comma 1 is treated as a single element. Okay, so this 1 1 and this 2 and this 3 and this 4. Okay, so these are the 4 elements for this list, so the length of the list is 4. Okay, the list method already I have discussed, that list method can be used for creating the list. Okay, only you need to write the list, and then in parenthesis you will pass the elements which you want to create the list from. So in this example you have passed list hello. So in this list hello, all the elements of hello has been treated as a single elements of the list. Okay, and this one you can see here, c equal to list a colon 101, b colon 201. So actually this is having a dictionary, so with this dictionary you have created a list, and this list is going to have the keys of the dictionary. So the first element will be the a and the second element will be b, because it is only storing the keys of the dictionary. Okay, so the keys are a and b, and 101 and 201 are the corresponding values of the dictionary. So it is not going to store the values, it is only going to store the keys of the dictionary. Okay, similarly you are having the index method. So the index method is going to provide you the index of that particular element. Okay, suppose if you are mentioning here 13 18 11 16 18 14, so the first element 18 is stored at the index 1. Okay, so 13 is stored at the index 0 and 18 is stored at the index 1. So if you are talking about this, so you will write l1.index18, so it will provide you the index of 18. So the index of 18 is 1. Okay, similarly if you write any element which is not there inside that list, and if you are going to access that index, it will show you the error. Now see, in this list 33 is not there, so if you are going to write list.index33, so it will provide you error because 33 is not present in this list. Okay, the next method is the append method. So in this append method, what you do, you just have this elements in the list, like colors equal to red, green and blue. If you write colors.append yellow, so it will just add this particular element which you have given in the append method, and it will add it at the end of the list. Okay, so red, green, blue was already present there, and yellow has been added in that list, so it will become a new list. Okay, so red, green, blue, yellow is the current list. Okay, the append does not return the new list. Obviously I have told you that the append is not going to return the new list, it will just manipulate the earlier list. Okay, similarly you are having the extend method also. So this extend method, what it does, this method is also used for adding multiple elements. Okay, so if you use this method, extend method, it will use multiple elements. Okay, so multiple elements will be inserted the list. For example, here t1 equal to abc, t2 is equals to td and e. So if you are going to write t1.extend t2, so what it will do, it will append this de list in the de elements in the of the list t2 in the t1 list. Okay, so if you are going to write t1 after that, it will print the abc and d and e together in that particular list. Okay, so here you can understand this. See here, it is mentioned t1.extend t2, and if you are going to print t1 after that, it will return this list. Okay, abc d and e. Okay, now the difference between append and extend: while append function adds one element to the list, extend can add multiple elements on the list. Okay, so it is very easy to understand that append will use only single element and it will add it at the end of the list, while the extend can be used for adding multiple lists, and also it will add the elements at the end of the list only, but the multiple elements can be added at once. Okay,
Now the insert method is there. Now insert method is used for adding the elements at a particular location. Okay, if you want to add it at a particular location, you can insert it. For example, here you can see we are having the list t1 is equals to aeu. Okay, so if you are going to insert element aeu inside that, so if you write t1.insert2, i, so that 2 will be inserted at, so what you are going to write, see, insert element 1 at index 2. So the element 1 is going to be stored at the index 2. Okay, so what you are going to get here, t1 aeiu. okay, so actually it is not 1, it is, if you see carefully, it is mentioned as I. So 2, i, so at index number 2 you are going to have the element as I. So the first element is a here, so it is stored at the 0 index, then 1 index, and then 2 index. So at 2 index earlier it was having a value as u, now the u will be replaced with I. Okay, so in this way you can mention any particular list and insert the elements in that list. Okay, now next method is the remove method. Okay, now let's see what is the difference between remove and pop. Okay, so first of all, let's discuss about the pop method also. Okay, now see here, we are having a list t1. Inside that, the list are here, the elements of the list are here, k, a, e, I, p, q, and u. So if you are going to write ele1 equal to t1.pop0, okay, so what it will do, it will pop the element present at the index 0. Okay, so that's in index 0, k was there, so it has popped the element. And if you are going to print ele1, now see, you are going to see that removed element here. Okay, now if you are going to write t1 after popping this list, okay, so you have mentioned this ele1 as t1.pop0. okay, so this ele1 was storing k, but if you are going to write t1 inside that, so this t1 is going to give you the list with the removed element of k. Okay, so the list is having a, e, I, p, q, and u. Earlier it was having k also, but since k has been popped, it is not mentioned in this t1. Okay, so in the similar way, you can pop any particular index, so the elements at that index will be popped. Okay, what the remove method does, the remove method removes the first occurrence of the given item from the list. It is used as per the following format. See, if you talk about the remove method, see, if you are having the list here, t1 is equals to a e p q a p, this all these elements, if you are going to write t1.remove a, so what it will do, it will remove the element a from this list. Okay, so if you are going to write t1.remove a, this t1 is going to be printed later on, and you will see that the a element has been removed from it. Okay, so what in pop you are doing, in pop you are giving the index of the element, but in remove you are giving the value of the element. Okay, so whatever value you are going to provide in remove, it is going to be removed from that particular list. Okay, next method is the reverse method. So this reverse method is used for reversing the list of the elements. Okay, so suppose if you are having t1 list as like this, e, I, q, a, q, p, and if you are going to write t1.reverse, and then you are going to print t1, so it will write the elements in the reverse order. That is, from the reverse order, if you are seeing, it is mentioning like this, p, then q, then a, then q, then I, then e. Okay, in the similar way, it has been printed in the reverse order. Okay, now there is a sort method also. In this sort method, what you do, in this sort method, the functions which are the list elements which are present, it has to be sorted. Okay, so if you are going to write t1.sort, so t1 is going to print the elements like this, a, e, I, p, q, q. Okay, why? Because it has sorted the list according to the alphabetical order. Okay, so by default it will sort the elements in the ascending order. If you want it to work in the descending order, you need to provide a false reverse attribute equal to true. So if you are going to write this reverse equal to true in list.sort, it will sort the elements according to the descending order. Okay, now this sorted function is also there. So the difference between the sort and sorted method, we need to understand this. So here you can see the sort and the sorted method is given as the difference. So the sort method modifies the list it is called on, that is, the sorted list is stored in the same list and new list is not created. If you are talking about the sorted function, it created a new list containing a sorted version of the list passed to it as argument. It does not modify the list passed as parameter. Okay, so if you are using the same list and if you want the list to be sorted in the particular set of elements only, and you don't want to create a new list, so you can use this sort method. But if you want to sort the elements into a different list, okay, so you can use the sorted function, okay, as it, I think it is easy to you, not very complex thing, okay. Now if you are going for this appending a list of elements to a list, so here you can see we have given some example how you can append elements in that list. So val was the list present earlier, so it was having the element 17, 24, 15 and 30, but if we are going to write val.extend 34, 27, so it will add these elements at the end of the list. So finally you are having this list 17, 24, 15, 30, 20, 34 and 27, okay. Now let's move on to the inserting on element on the list. If you want to insert the elements, I've told you that you need to give the value and the index. So here you can see val equal to 17, 24, 15, 30. If you are going to write val.insert 2, 33. So at 2 index, it is going to insert the element as 33. So earlier it was having 15 as element at index 2, but now the element will be changed to 33. Why we are able to change the elements inside the list? Because lists are the mutable elements, mutable sequences. Already I have told you that mutable sequences means those sequences which are able to change their value in place. Okay, so that's why modification in the values of the list is possible. Okay, here you can see we have updated the list. List 1 equal to 10, 12, 14, 16, and we have given the index of that particular element which we want to change. List 1, 2 equal to 24. So earlier list 1, 2 was having the element as 14. Now that 14 has been modified to 24. So if you are going to print list 1 again, you are going to get a new modified list, that is 10, 12, 24 and 16. Okay. Now the next thing is deleting an element. How can you delete a particular element from the list? So for deleting the element, you are having the pop method also. Pop we have already discussed, that it will pop the element which has been given inside that particular index. Okay. So val.pop2 will pop the index at, will pop the value present at the index 2. Okay, but if you want to use a delete function, so for delete function, see, we are having a list here, list equal to 1, 2, 3, this particular list is given. Now if we write del list 10, okay, what it will do, it will go to the 10th index of this list, and whatever the element will be present at the 10th index, it will be deleted, okay. But if you give a subset of list inside this, okay, or index of list, so see here, if you are writing del lst 10 colon 15, so if you are going to write 10 colon 15, it will start deleting from the elements 10, that is the index 10, and then it will go till the index 14, and all the elements from 10 to 14 index will be deleted. Okay, so the element at the index 10 and 11 and 12 and 13 and 14 will be deleted out from this list, and you can see the final list is here. Okay, so be careful that we are talking about the index here, we are not talking about the value. So you have to go at the particular index and you have to see what value is present there, and whatever the value will be there, it will be deleted from it. Okay, now see, sorting a list, I have already told you that how you can use the sort method. Okay, so that's it, students, for this chapter. There are certain set of programmings also that I'm already discussing in the offline classes. So the students who are facing problems in this programming part, just go and search for the methods which I have been used. Okay. If you are not able to understand this programmings, you can write it in the comment section that which particular program, at which page number you are not able to understand, and if it will be possible, I will make a video of it. Okay, otherwise you can attend the offline classes and you can understand the programmings easily. Okay, so that's it for today, student. We'll meet in the next video lecture. Thank you.